Everyone, in this tutorial I am going to talk about the binary trees in C. What is the tree in C? A tree is a finite set of elements called nodes. A tree has a unique node called the root node, where the remaining nodes are a disjoint collection of subtrees. If node R has T1 until Tn as subtrees, then R1 until Rn are the children of R. A node with no children calls leaf node. The example is this one. We have a root node which has three children, and each children, two of children, has children. That part and that part calls subtree. And the last children, H, hasn't any children, and it is leaf node. All C, D, E, G, sorry, G, H are leaf nodes. A binary tree is a tree whose elements have two children. A binary tree considered as a data structure is an object made up of elements that are characterized by two link fields called left children and right children. Each link must point at a new object not already pointed at or be null. In this representation, a leaf node has both left and right child as the value null. The following structures and type specification will be used to define binary trees. Also, we include header files, assert, studio, stdlib for checking a condition and for allocating space storage in memory. And we are going to make a character data as a local macro variable, and we are going to define a structure node and with three elements. One of them is a character of type data, and both last elements are pointed of structure, the same structure node, one for left and one for right. And because we need more functions, few functions to define and create our tree, we are going to gather all those functions and define of a structure node in a header file, a local header file. And in the main program, we are going to call only the functions, and it makes that program goes quicker without loaded in one file, and it's going to be more it's going to be better. Okay. A key advantage of a binary tree over a linear list is that elements are normally rich. On average, in an algorithmic number of linked traversal. This change in time efficiency for retrieving information is at the expense of the space needed to store the extra link field per element. In binary tree, we can make or reach a tree, make and write or print a tree in three different methods. One in order, or pre-order, or post-order. In order method, we are starting with the left subtree. And after that, we are going to print the root, and then we are going to print the right subtree. In pre-order, we are going to start to print the root, and then left subtree, and then right subtree. In post-order, we are going to start with the printing of left subtree, then right subtree, and the last root. This is an example of a binary tree. G is the root node, and it has two children, D and I. D has two children, B and F. B has two children, A and C. D, F has one child, E. I has two children, H and J. As you see, if we take the in order, left subtree, root, right subtree. So left, left, left is A, which is the leaf, A, and then root, and then right. A, B, C, and return to root because the left has been done. Then it is root, D, and it is going to right, which has E and F as root, and then G, and then that child has left H, and then root I, and then right J. Also A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J in pre-order definition, in order method. How we use it in order method? Okay, we are going to define a in order function which parameter is a structure, and if root is not null, it means that it has something, then we are going to call in order root of left. We have there, and we are going to call this, and we are going to left, 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 and we are going to right print the data. In this tree, everything is character, and we are going to print its character, and we are going to call to the right side, because it is binary. We are ready with left, then we are going to the right. In pre-order, we are starting with root, and we are going, and then left, and then right. Then we are going to start. If root is not null, then write its character, and then call to pre-order root left, and after that one, we are going to call to pre-order root of right. In post order, we are going to start with left, and then right, and then root, and we are going to call first post order of left, post order of right, and then print the information. In pre-order, we start with root G, and then left, and then right. We are going to write G, and then left, and it is D, and then left again, it is B, and then left again, it is A, and it is C, and then right, it is F, E, and then left, it is that root, it's right, that root, I, and left, and right. In the same way, we are going to use it in post order, it is left, right, root. We are going to left, right, root. This one is left, right, left, right, root, and that one is ready. The left part is ready. We are going to here left, right, root, and then root. Okay. To create a tree, how we create a tree? We are going to define a function of the type structure B-tree, and we are going to make a new node, and we are going to return, because it is the function is a type structure, we are going to return a size, the size of structure. We make a storage of the size of a structure, and we are going to initialize the node with data d1 and two structures. And inside the function, we are declaring a variable t of type structure, and we are going to call the function new node, which explains here, and it is going to make a storage in the memory of the size structure, and t of d we are going to initialize with d1, t of left it's that, because it is a structure, it is going to take that p1 structure, and t of right you are going to initialize with p2, which is the structure. We will use these routines as primitives to create a binary tree from data values stored in an array. There is a very nice mapping from the indices of a linear array into nodes of a binary tree. We do this by training the value a of I and let it have as child value a of 2 multiple I plus 1 and a of 2 multiple by I plus 2. Then we map a of 0 into the unique root node of the resulting binary tree. Its left child will be a of 1, and its right child will be a of 2. The function create tree embeds this mapping. The formal parameter size is the number of nodes in the binary tree. Now we are making a function of the type structure create tree with a array of characters, which is the strings or array of characters, and with an integer I, which indicates the start index of the array, and the size is the total number of elements in A. The int is starting with 0, but you can manually, you can start from any other place in the tree, but usually we start from 0 to see the whole tree, but you can use you can start from any number in the array. And if size if i is bigger than or equal size, return 0, return null, because it cannot accept, it's going wrong. Otherwise we are going to return init node, initialization of node of d1, which is a of I. We started with 0, and we are going to create, to call the same function inside it with the element thereafter and the element for left and the element for right. Okay, now we are going to see all those things in our program. I have made the header file tree.h, and I have included in our main program, and I am going to declare a variable named tree of the type structure, and I am going to define an array of characters of type data equal, and I am going to call it GDIBFHJACE, which is the order of GDBACEFHIJ. And I am going to, no, it is not, It is not so. Sorry. It is G D I B F H J A C E. Because I want to get the pre-order and the in-order that it is right here, and then pre-order and post-order that we have it here as result. I am going to create tree by nodes, which is the data, and I am going to start from zero, from index zero, and the number of elements is 10. The size of that array is 10. And I am going to call the function in order of tree to print the tree with in order method, and then call pre-order function and make with the parameter tree with pre-order method, and then with the post-order method. What I have in tree.h? Yes, I have include assert studio stdlib, and I have declared a variable data as a local macro variable which is of type character, and I have defined structure node with three elements, data D, two structures, pointed left, pointed right, and I have called, because it is type definition, I have called it node, and I have declared a node, a pointed of structure B3 of type node. That node is the same. Now I am going to define the in order method of the tree, and our tree is called root, and if root is not null, then call in order left, and print the character, and call in order right. In pre-order, we are in the root, and we are going to print the character in the root, and then we are going to call pre-order, call left, and then pre-order right. And in post-order, we are going to call first the root of call again the function post-order of root of left and then right, and then we are going to print the data, which is the root character. In B3, we have defined as a local global variable, and it is a pointer. We are going to define the function new node of type B3, which is a pointer, and we are going to return the an storage made by size of the structure, and we are going to call the initialize node function as we saw before. I show you before, and we are going to create our tree as, and I am writing as I have shown you before, that it has parameter string of character, array of character, and start integer, start index, and the size of the total size of the array. And if size is bigger than zero, then it is return null and it is not working. Otherwise, we are going to use that statement. Now we are going to run. Yes, I have used the A until J in this order, and after in order method we have A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, and in pre-order we have G, D, B, A, C, F, E, I, H, J, and in post order we have A, C, B, E, F, D, H, J, I, and ending with G. Okay, now I am going to see if I can add something here. We can also use a general linked list as tree, and we have started with A, and then A has a one child only, B, and B has two children, C and F. C has two children, a null and a D, and D has two children, E and null, and E has one child, null, which is the, it is its next. And F has two children, G and H, and all of them has their next, all of them has their next pointing on null. And what we can do here, it is only make a structure and the number of child as integer, character of type data, which is defined here, and the last element is an structure which indicates siblings, and we are going to use that function new genoid and return an allocation of storage in the memory and initialize the node with the same as we had before, and we are going to initialize, and if you want it in your main program, you are going to use those functions T0 until T8, and we initialize the character A, which is here, and then the B character, we made initialize the B, and its sibling to one is F and H. B has siblings F and H, and then T2, they initialize the node 3, and it has sibling D, and D has sibling E, and it is here. C has two siblings D and E. And then at last we are going to make all of them null as their next, and the last one is the making G, G node, and its last and its siblings siblings last has null. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.